everyone, welcome and welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, it's your first time, super welcome. And if you've been here, welcome back. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make your very own custom GIF using Keynote. I am now an Apple certified teacher, and what that means is that I have a basic knowledge in Apple software and Apple products. I'm able to either teach someone else, a fellow peer, or use these tools within my classroom to further foster student learning. As an Apple educator, as an Apple teacher, they give you a nice little logo that you can put in your email so you can show off and tell everybody that you now know how to use Apple programs for your own purposes or for instructional purposes. So it's something I'm pretty excited about and look forward to doing further trainings with Apple as well as Google. I'm gonna show you a skill that I learned in one of my workshops. By the way, it took me one day to complete the whole training and receive my certificate to say that I am Apple Teacher Certified. I'm gonna show you a skill that I learned in this video, how to use Keynote to make your own custom GIF. Now, I do know that there are websites like Giphy and others, a few others that you can use to make your own GIF. But if you wanna know how to do it on your laptop yourself, with your own personal images and your own personal text, you can do this using Keynote. So stay tuned and enjoy. The first thing we need to do is to open up the Keynote application on our MacBooks. And then you're gonna go ahead and choose your template. You have a choice between a standard width and a wider width. I'm gonna go ahead and choose the standard size, and I'm gonna choose the white template for my presentation. Once I've made my choice, I'm gonna go ahead and select the number of frames that I would like for the purpose of creating my GIF. You technically need about, I'd say 2 to 5 on average frames for your GIF. In this case, I'm probably gonna use a little bit more. They do have some selections of basic layout that you can choose from, but because I know I'm gonna be adding my own text and information, I'm gonna choose the plain layout. I'm gonna go ahead and start adding some text. I'm gonna add some text. I'm gonna change the size, choose the font, and play around a little bit just to get an idea of what it is that I wanna say. Now, because this is back to school time frame, I'm choosing to use an example for a teacher, a welcome back to science, welcome to science class, welcome to Miss Jane's classroom. You can use this for any particular custom gift that you'd like to make. Maybe it's a happy birthday, maybe it's a happy new year, but in this case, for this example, I'm using a teaching example because I'll most likely use this with my students for a welcome back gift. So I'm going ahead, I'm changing the fonts. I am playing around a little bit with some animations here just to see how I want to set this all up. So as you look on the screen to your right-hand side, you will see a number of options of how to animate, how to select your font, how to change your size. You have a number of features here on the right-hand side of your screen. So I'm still playing around with the text, which you will do as well. Adding some emojis. I want to make it a little bit interesting. So I'm adding my crown to my name. Now, I haven't found an emoji that I love, so I've sent myself my emoji. I've sent a text to myself, which comes up on my MacBook. I'm going to copy this emoji and I'm going to go ahead and paste it into Keynote. Once I've pasted it, I'm going to go ahead and change the size, move it around just to get an idea of where it is that I want to place it, and then I am going to animate the frame a little later using the magic move, so you'll get to see a little bit more about that. I'm duplicating some slides here because once you're using a magic move, you need to make sure that there are similarities between the slides that are moving. The object that is moving needs to be on more than one slide. So I'm making some duplications, moving it around so I can get that position right. Because once I animate, it will move from the first slide, from its first position, and make its way to whatever the final position is that I am deciding right now.
So you see I'm choosing some actions here. You can choose to push the image to the back so you have text in the front, or you can push the image to the front where the text will be somewhere in the back or on the side. The choices are yours. Play around with Keynote. There's so many options. Here I've pushed the image to the back because I wanted the text to the front, and now I'm trying to block the text so it shows up present in front of the image. So I'm looking for the fill, which I'm going to make my way back to go down to fill. So I'm going to select white. So therefore I can have that text blocked out, and then I can shift it down and get it in the perfect spot in front of my image. You can choose to do this as well, or you can just choose to add your own custom text that you've probably already made in an app somewhere, send it to yourself, import it into Keynote, and move it around however you may choose. Okay, so once I've got that done, I'm gonna spend these next couple of slides just shifting things around, moving things around, just playing around to see how I want this animation to happen exactly, and where I want, what my final frame to be. So I'm playing around with the magic move here so you can see what happens when it moves. A little sample. Awesome. So that looks like the final frame that I want it to be, as well as Science Rocks. Playing around again with some more animations for the rest of the slides. Then I'm gonna go through to make sure that everything is animated, that the font is the font that I want it to be, that the size is the size that I want it to be. Welcome seems a little boring, so I'm gonna go ahead and add an emoji here. Welcome, kids. Science also seems a little boring, science class, so I'm gonna go ahead and add some more emojis here to jazz it all up. I'm gonna change the font. I'm gonna play around because I really want this to be unique, and I want it to be, you know what, welcome to science class with Miss James. I'm so happy to have you here. Great. Jazzing it up. Ooh, and I'm going to go ahead and add some animation again. Yeah, I like this one. Nice. Awesome. Shifted. Now I'm aligning the welcome and science class. I noticed that one frame was higher than the other, so I'm aligning them, making sure that X and Y axis is the same. Checking the rest of the slides, going through, and once I've decided that my heart is content, I'm gonna go ahead and hit file, I'm gonna go ahead and hit export, and I'm gonna export as an animated GIF. I'm gonna make sure that I have my total slides accounted for, slides 1 to 7. I'm gonna leave the frames per minute, the frame rates. This is just how fast or how slow you want your GIF to be. I'm gonna leave it at 24. I'm gonna save it, choose a name for what I want it to be saved as, where I want it to be saved on my computer, then I'm gonna hit export. And once it exports, when you click on the file itself, it's not gonna show up as a GIF. Once it's completely exported, you will have to open it up in your browser in order for it to show up as an animated GIF. So here it is as a file on my computer. It's just a bunch of slides in a document. So now I'm gonna have to open up my browser. I'm gonna drag it into the browser, hit enter, and now I have my animated GIF. So I'm looking at it now, I'm analyzing, I'm seeing where it's glitching a little bit, moving a little slower than I would like for it to move. So now I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna make some changes because I'm not quite happy with this final product. So I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna make some changes. I'm probably gonna duplicate some more slides. I'm gonna change the timing of each slide, how long it waits before it shifts. I'm gonna export it again and check out the next product to see if I like this one better. And that's pretty much it, guys. And you can do the same. Whatever it is that you want, you can add it to your GIF, play around with the timing, play around with your emojis. Here we go. Awesome, see, I changed the font. I love it, yes. Sweet, I've got a spin too. Science Rocks. Amazing. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned and let me know how you are going to make your own gift.